to create a home environment where our children want to stay home. That's why it's very important, especially for moms, to hold back on the nagging. Because our children get very, very tired. Now, if a teenager has a choice, if I'm home and I'm always reprimanded and I'm getting scoldings and I'm told how lazy and irresponsible I am and I'm tidy and I'm messy and I'm good for nothing. And that is what he gets when he comes home. Now, he's out with his friends. His friends think he's wow, he's amazing, he's a really funny guy, and he's so much fun to chill out with. And this gives this teenager a sense of being wanted, being appreciated, and being supported. And so at the end of the day, if he had to choose family where he doesn't feel good about himself, and his self-esteem is shaken, versus friends. And, you know, most of us, of course, want our children to hang out with friends that would be a positive influence. But if the negative influence, the peer pressure, where these they are luring him into drinking alcohol or smoking, but they are so much fun, then there is a tendency for our children to go in that direction. So how is moms and dads, as parents, how do we help is actually changing the home environment. We've got to create a home environment where we are there, where there's positive reinforcement, where there's sharing. So don't wait. You know, opportunities. Most of our conversations with our children is always about school. That's all we talk about. School, homework, exams, tutors. That's all we talk about. But we need to expand a little bit more because we want to build that relationship with our children so that we are not the last to know. That's important. And if we can build that relationship, that communication, sometimes we can talk about issues that we read in the newspaper about teen bullying, right? Or gangsters, and use that as an opportunity to share. So we don't have to wait to find out that our children have joined a gang and then pull them in for a lecture and threatening them, you know, as long as you're under my roof, you do what I tell you. That's no longer necessary. But if we use this opportunity when it pops up to say, hey, look at this, what would influence these teenagers? Why do you think bullying occurs? How can we avoid it? And use that as an opportunity to communicate so that your child then feels that there's understanding and support from home. So once there's a possibility of him being lured, he will come back and tell you, Mom, you know, I've got these friends in school and they're telling me that I should join a gang. It will be so much better. Then you're open, you see, to these kind of things that are going on in school. So the relationship is better.